Hey everybody, I'm Mac.
I'm Millie.
And this is McMillie.
Well, the love is so strong, we finish each other's
wine coolers.
Never a wine cooler. I'm classy.
And we are back.
Wine cooler.
With episode 2 of Avatar The Last Airbender.
And he wants to risk it all by being as loud as possible for this baby.
It's a reaction.
You can react quietly.
No, we can't.
Yes, you can.
No, we can't. Because yes, it's all whispery and boring and low energy whispery.
First of all, I've seen whispers be very exciting.
Nope.
He's annoying. Watch him wake up this baby.
But we are excited to get back into this because it's Avatar. And we're not about to sit here and binge through it as much as we would love
as
to.
As much as we'd love to, we cannot do that.
Want it to stay here as long as it can. But you guys, we're not going to waste any time dilly-dallying. Please follow us on Instagram, at McMillieReacts.
And before you do that, go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Please hit that bell so you are notified whenever we post something new. Still working toward our 1K goal. Looking for that 1K goal. Come on, keep it up. And please follow us on Patreon. Same tag. At McMillieReacts.
Mm-hmm. And please check out all the reactions that we have to come. There are new shows coming out for the next few months. So all the stuff that we're behind on,
we're going to get you.
They're going to get posted at some point. But we're going to get the new first.
Yeah. We're going to try to get through this. I just got this baby to sleep. Let's see what happens.
Episode 2, Avatar. Hopefully no more bullshit like the grand shit.
Yeah, that was... You know, was the previous live-action Avatar in partnership with Nickelodeon as well?
Probably.
Wow. So Nickelodeon was like, by the way, we had our hands on this too. We're just trying to make up for the nonsense we gave you in 2010.
I'm sure it'll turn out. You probably just misplaced it. Keep in mind, the notebook didn't find the Avatar. You did. Your notebook may have been useful in collecting your thoughts.
Zuko's
your
perfect.
Your unceasing effort is what led you to the Avatar.
He ran!
That was too high of a register. His voice has been perfect, but that was too high.
That was a lot for me, y'all. Please chime in the comments if that was a lot for you. He ran! Oh, shit.
How many places can there be for an avatar to hide?
The whole world.
Island is only a few hours from here. According to this, Avatar Kyoshi was the fiercest of warriors and the master.
Get
of
your tail at the microphone.
Maybe something in her shrine will help me control my power before
you kill someone.
Before it happens again.
Not before you kill someone. God damn, Zaka.
Ever since he came into our lives, things have changed for me. Before I met him, I couldn't bend enough water to fill a thimble. And now look what I can do. And it's after a single day.
That wasn't really explained either.
I don't know about you, but I can't.
I think I forgot to mention that gripe.
I got a couple gripes with it, but I'm just trying to enjoy it. But I do got a couple gripes with it.
Momo?
Is Momo finally coming into the picture? This is about that time.
Katara, something's wrong with your bag.
Cute.
Hey! That's R2!
What is that? A white glimmer! The sky used to be filled with them.
My dear Katara, this scroll has been passed down among the waterbenders of our tribe for generations. It contains everything you need to know to begin your bending education.
But with the Fire Nation hunting for benders, it was just too dangerous for you to have.
More Grand Grand.
But now that you've gone out into the world, you should take what belongs to you.
Stop and talking.
Always will be.
He hates this granny character.
I really do.
He hates her.
Fine, we'll go to Kyosha.
I don't carry the same disdain.
Hey.
I just think there's certain places you shouldn't be in.
There's something I have to do first.
Visually, this is gorgeous. Good God. The acting, it's just not giving what it needs to be gave for me right now. But I do really like it.
Wanna join us, Mama?
Mama?
Yeah, he looks like a Mama, doesn't he? Like how you look like a Sokka?
Can't argue with that.
But she tastes like chicken.
Zuko, you must try this. It's got... what's it got?
Quail bole.
Quail bole. Very good for...
vitality?
Vitality!
One thing you must learn is how to get what you want without divulging your true intentions. You must use your tact, your empathy.
But most importantly, you need to have sticky rice.
What?
Uncle, there's no time for this.
Yoshi Warriors.
What's happening?
Watch out!
Hey!
You are trespassing on sacred ground. Stop! You're making a mistake! He's the Avatar!
Ridiculous. There would have been signs if he was the Avatar.
There you go.
That was a little too, That was a little too... It's okay.
For a 100 years, it passes.
Kyoshi Island has remained safe from the
assuming it has something to do with him landing in the circle.
We expect the outside world
to do the same. We care to cause any trouble. All I want is to learn more about Avatar Kyoshi. Isn't that what this place is about? Keeping the memory alive?
Are you not a threat?
Maybe not, but the next visitors might be. We can't start making exceptions.
It's a big responsibility, all these people's lives in your hands. Personally, I think that responsibility is very serious. I'm the guardian of my village.
Okay, Sokka.
You.
Yep.
A guardian. So, how are you protecting your people if you're here?
What? I'm not. I mean, I am. I may not physically be there, but still. That is, I'm... I have to save the world first.
Boy, okay.
Katara, how does it go again? Protecting things from protecting the village?
Prince Zuko, what an honor.
He's staying in the movies and in the shows, man.
To our humble base, what can
this
I do
one in particular, he in every
saying,
show.
Me.
I think
excuse
I saw him on HBO Succession.
We've been at sea a long time,
and our manners have grown as rusty as our anchors. General,
is it Succession? Industry. I like.
There's food in the village hall.
You just gonna look. Aggravating.
There's some reverse sexism. For those complaining about the lack of sexism.
Over sex.
Mm-hmm.
I really do think the waterbending is pretty. Doing that. You'll get it.
What is it? Chow's bone. It's gone.
Chow? He heard something about a flying cow near Kyoshi Island, so he set sail at dawn.
A flying cow? He knows. About the Avatar, somehow he found out.
This slow turnaround, like, ooh.
Because it's the reverse.
It's cute. Nigga, why are you so clumsy?
It was that whole thing of, let me get behind you and show you how to golf. They just flip the dynamic.
It's cute.
Yeah, I don't mind it.
It was the slow-mo turnaround for me. They're like, okay, y'all. Okay. Let me see the bitch. Let me see. Avatar State.
Hey. It's about time.
I'm sorry. I didn't know how to reach you. I didn't know I could reach you.
I think I'm getting the hang of it.
You need to turn your opponent's power against them.
Reflect their strength.
Okay.
I think you're a real warrior.
Clean face after that heavy ass makeup, but okay. I expected a clean face.
Really? It's TV.
You can tone down the makeup a little bit to where it's like, okay, this is it's a natural beat. It's not supposed to be a beat at all.
I never had the courage to leave.
This all happens so fast.
The bell.
You hear it too?
We have to go.
There you go.
It's the town alarm. Someone's coming.
He in the Avatar state. Y'all just gonna have to take care of it. Period. Okay, she flung his ass like, please.
And how many have already been hurt because you haven't been here? Run away from your responsibilities again, and even more will be hurt.
Damn.
Being the Avatar means putting your duties above all else, even your life.
Why is she so tall?
Because she was always tall in the cartoon.
I know, but why is she so goddamn tall? She's like towering over my nigga, though.
I saw what was at stake.
So she can be accurate.
I know, I get it, but like, damn, this is like a lot. During the animated series, did anyone else think that Neil Patara and Zuko had like a thing? Like ship them? I ship them.
Well, it's not this season.
Obviously not, but there was a point during that animated series where I shipped these two.
You wanted to know about the power
of
the
Avatar. You serious, y'all?
I will show you what that power can do.
Hey, Avatar Kyoshi. What's up, bitch?
Impossible.
Damn. Avatar Kyoshi was that bitch. Can I see her story? Sorry, I'm very interested in that. Yes, Avatar Kyoshi, I dig this. I'm digging this. Right. She says, stand down, little nigga. Let me show you something. She's like scary, and I love it. Because what the fuck?
Hey!
full on possession. Look at my knees and legs, they ashy, please.
So this means you don't want to go home anymore? What else does she tell you?
We need to get to the Northern Water Tribe, because something terrible is going to happen there. Something only I can stop.
Alright, North, it is then. We just gotta get there before the firebenders catch up to us.
The waterbending masters, they are the best in the world. They can train you.
So don't worry, kid, you don't have to do this alone.
You have me, Tara, and the flying ball of fur. What more do you need?
Like I walked into that one.
Sokka really is perfect, you know.
To your supreme eminence, the great flame of the world. I am but a humble servant in the southern seas.
He ain't shit.
I have
he ain't
for you,
shit.
The critical nature.
He ain't shit.
I know this information.
I love this temple. It's so fucking. This palace is just so fucking accurate to the show, and I love it. Fire Lord, sorry.
The Avatar has returned.
Thank you, Lord. Okay, episode 2 of Avatar: The Last Airbender.
Well,
I
liked it.
I did like this episode. I love the Kyoshi Warriors. I think the style of fighting and the culture they have specifically on Kyoshi Island is so interesting and unique and special in the show. And I think that translated very well onto the screen for this.
Yep, the pacing of this episode was much better than
much
the first one.
Much better, Jesus.
Which helped retain interest. I mean, I'm already going to be interested because it's Avatar.
Right. Very biased, but hey.
Yes.
They still did a good job.
I'm going to be critical, and I'm going to be.
Yeah, here we go.
But the pacing was great. We weren't focusing too much on a backstory that we did get to see in the original that took away from the pacing of the present day, which is great. I am not opposed to them sort of switching the dynamic between Sokka and,
Suki.
Yes, I'm not opposed to changing the dynamic. I know people keep bitching about the whole sexism thing, but Sokka's still funny. He still has the irony,
the
sarcasm.
The faces, perfect.
He has the sarcasm of Sokka. I'm still fine with that. Where I do, as you heard during the episode, she has a problem with the acting. And I can see where she is getting at.
There's just moments where I just feel like a little more guidance. Just a little more guidance would have been helpful for the actors we had.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's mostly Aang.
My poor baby Aang.
And where I do agree with some criticism is that I see the flashes that they keep trying to interject of him having a fun, loving personality. I see the flashes, but there's just way too much seriousness with pretty much his entire character at this point in time.
Yeah, because he's still pretty much a goofball at this point, the Aang we know and love. And the serious moments kind of hit him like a ton of bricks. Like, oh, are we serious now? Okay.
Which is, it's realistic.
Right?
It's realistic.
And it helps us, like, see his arc. Like, it helps us see his arc for what it is. And it's a very dramatic arc where he really grows up rather quickly. Not this quickly, But he you see that the pressure on him to literally save the world makes him grow up in a hurry. And ooh, a storm of brewing. And I loved during the animated series to see that push and pull of him really not wanting to grow up, really wanting to keep his childlike nature, wanting to stay a kid so badly. And that's partly what made me fall in love with Aang, was and really empathize with Aang, was that his childhood was literally being ripped from him, and it was like not a switch, quick rip off the band-aid like it seems to be happening here. It was really agonizing and slow, and you watched him hate it too, like hate having to have his childhood robbed like that. But and it's not fair, and I that is so painful and beautiful, and it's just missing here in this series for me.
Yeah, agreed. It makes sense because this is the real world, and obviously there is no higher stake than him being the Avatar and his duty to save the world. It doesn't get any higher than that, so I get it, but I think we're rushing it because we're only doing eight episodes
period? Okay.
For this first season. Right. So it's like, we have to get through it. We have to get to the Northern Air Temple. Not Northern Air Temple. Northern Water Tribe. We got to get to the climax of this season. So we got to boom, 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 boom. And though I understand it, yes, it is slightly annoying. And it's slightly a change of his character, because we spend maybe 1 minute total per episode seeing his goofy, fun self.
Yeah, it's
the
just
air
sucks.
Ball, playing with the kids.
I do love that you...
The rest of it is just... I gotta save the world.
Y'all gave me some tears. And while as an actor, I do find it far more interesting to watch the actor hold back the tears as opposed to letting them flow. That still hit so weird to me.
Those are definitely fake tears.
Right, like, give us my drops real quick. Okay, roll the camera. Okay, deliver the line.
It's fake tears, and you were waiting for it to drop at the last minute and didn't drop. And they just said, well, this is the best take, so we're going to keep it anyhow.
That's what it felt like. That's exactly what it felt like. But I do appreciate them bringing back that classic, airball, spin, ride around on it, smack into the statue. Like, yes. I do appreciate that as, like...
Like I said, that was only 1 minute of his goofiness, and then the rest of it is seriousness. But, I mean, I'm fine being on board with his acting, seeing how he is a new actor, clearly.
He has a lot of ground to gain.
But, well, yes.
I do.
And the fact that I love that, I mean, he's not doing a terrible job.
No.
It's just that there's certain moments you can see it shine through. But all the other characters around him help bring it. Sokka, Zuko.
Sokka's eating them up.
Uncle Iroh.
Uncle Iroh's eating them up.
And Katara was better in this episode than the first. She had more lines and more of an effect in this episode. They almost tried to fuck it up with Grand Grand at the beginning.
Why do you hate her?
But the rest of the cast, this ensemble, seems like fabulous actors.
He hates her.
And they are bringing it all together, so I will not be a stickler over the moments with Aang. And like I said, the pacing was better, although we get it, it's 8 episodes, so that's why we're rushing his character development just a little bit. But I'm not opposed to that either. I think this was a great episode. If I had to rate this out of 5, what are we doing? Air, water emblems?
Yeah.
If I had to rate this out of 5... What did I get the first episode? 4.5, I think.
I think we gave it a solid four.
Four?
The first episode.
I gave this one a 4.5.
I think I would give this one a 4.5, too. And I think the 0.5 for me was brought on by seeing Avatar Kyoshi.
I was going to say the exact same thing.
Go in. And I was like, ooh. And watching the scale of Avatar Kyoshi's height as opposed to Aang, and watching that conversation happen, and watching, you know, Avatar Kyoshi go, like, nigga, ain't nobody playing with you. And, like, you know, and I felt like that speech would have hit so much harder if we kept some of his childlike innocence, because it feels like Kyoshi's really trying to, like, drive this message home, and Aang is not getting it. And that made sense in the animated series, but not here for me. It just felt overtly harsh and, like, yeah. But, you know, that wasn't the fault of the actor. The actor did her fucking job, okay? That was the writing and the pacing of, you know, that was production. But I love seeing her work them four elements and like, this is how Avatar is supposed to, you see? See?
The action and special effects was definitely up there, especially in that moment. Kiyoshi going ham. That was great.
That was excellent.
That was nice.
And she was beautiful. That scene.
And let me mention by that, it seems that, I'm assuming, we're saving, damn it. All the names just keep slipping me right now. Roku.
Avatar Roku.
We're saving him, I'm assuming, for the end, but not complete end. It's not complete end.
Because he's the Avatar before him, so yes. They have to save him.
But the finale, clearly, we're going to be referencing the last water Avatar. I don't remember his name whatsoever.
I forgot to.
But I'm assuming Roku, we're going to fit in some point, but we're not rushing to get to him first.
Mm-hmm. And I believe we're going to
save him for next season.
Probably, because where this season has to end would be the moon scene. The scene, yes, where the moon.
But, you know, Roku was there in the beginning as the last Avatar. He was one of the first ones to guide him.
Mm-hmm. Because they were, they were in the temple with all the Avatars in there.
But he does go to Roku's island. So I think we're getting there.
We're gonna get there because so, yes, that's what gives him the prophecy. Season,
we saw that in the preview.
Because he didn't understand the prophecy until he went there and was like, "Oh, you have to do this at a certain time. Yeah. You have to fight the Fire Lord and fuck him up." So you and yeah, that's okay. Okay, I get it. We're on the same page.
Yeah. So we mixed up the order just a tad bit. But it's fine, because we will get him this season. I was thinking, like, would they save him until we do the fire season? But no.
I might have to go ahead and rewatch the animated series. Cool. I might have to go ahead, just so I can have a better talk with y'all. You know, I want to have a better talk, because we could talk all day.
Yep, but we're not going to keep talking all day. You guys, tell us what you would rate this out of 5. In the comments below.
The water insignias. And while you're commenting, please like and subscribe to this channel and hit that bell so you are notified whenever we post something new. Please pay attention to our lineup. We got new shows and they are coming in hot over the next month. Please go ahead and follow us on Instagram at McMillieReacts and follow us on our Patreon.
Patreon, where you can get full unedited reactions of everything that we react to up there first before the YouTube gets them. Please, guys, go over there.
We're going
to be uploading things, like I said, before YouTube.
So, uncut.
It's cheap.
And you get to see me nod off a couple times. I'm sorry.
And we got one of the millions of McMillions by joining this family. We love you guys.
We love you.
The baby stays asleep. Yes.
We did it.
This has been McMillie. Till next time.
Stay silly. You didn't do the fist thing. Do the fist thing. Stay silly. Bye.
Get...